graduated from art school. Amazing. I basically didn't do much art that year, and those books.
Drawings.
I think a hand cut, they were small handful of those drawings, basically all I did.
Wow.
You know.
Yeah. And
that one with the little figures? Yeah. That one maybe came later. That one may have even been kind of here for a moment. But when you were making the animation, like a band making it, always more like this. There's more experimental techniques,
right.
You know.
I was thinking when they were talking about computer and whatever, like art and that art, I thought, you know, if that's really valid, well, animation is a lot of my because you take I don't know if you use the computer at that time, but you take one drawing and you reduplicate it and make it, it'll change a little bit.
Well, we did that by using something called a light table and registered drawings that exactly the same thing.
Yeah.
That, which is now what we did is now referred to as classical animation.
Yes.
You know, compared to computer animation, because in computer you just alter the image,
record it and then alter it. Yeah.
Well, we did that too under the camera. What we called under camera animation, where I did this thing called. Little film that I was an art student called Freight Train Blues, and I took a guitar and harmonica piece from by a couple of American blues artists, Sonny Carey and Brian Lee, and they're like train, you know, and then I animated this train going through the mountains. But what I did is did a drawing with felt pen, with waterfillable felt pen on plastic, and then I drew the train, photographed two frames of it, and then erased the back of the train and had a little run and just change things around and then had to fill in the mountain behind, and so it's beautiful animation to do. It's very rough, you know.
Yeah.
And there's a guy who's quite well known drawer, I love to have his show in here, from South Africa, whose name is again is escaping me. He does charcoal drawings of the city and then there's a businessman or something, and then suddenly his arm goes up and his briefcase was flying through the air, and he just animates it. And there's a smear mark right behind. Then he put the drawings in the show. I saw a huge, comprehensive worldwide drawing show at the Bank of Art Gallery, and his work was in it, including the drawing from the animation.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's a lot of that, you know.
Yeah. I love that kind of stuff. It's because that's like you can draw very loosely,
yes.
You know, very gesturally.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
With cartoon animation, with that kind of production, it's really difficult. Well, some things are done that way, you know. Matter of fact, there was one guy made a film and for the National Film Board, and he had instead of the inkers and painters, the people that took the animation and transferred it onto celluloid sheets, he had them coloring it with alcohol-based stuff. So the whole crew, yeah, he's going to the room, there's only people watching the back table, and the rest of the painters are gone.